And so in thanksgiving for this faithfulness of the living spirit that created us out of itself, that called us into radiant expression, and that walks every step of life's way with us, I know that some of you want to give thanks for the good that has been yours in 2016. I invite you now to come forward and share with us briefly. There is my beloved Tony with a handheld mic, so he will be the runner. Thank you, Tony. Just put your hand up and then... I said put your hand up.
He knew.
It's time so everybody can see you. Lovely.
Oh, boy. Reverend John knows everything.
Me not said nothing.
So... 2016 is unreservedly the best year I've ever had in my entire life.
Wow.
To date. And I had all sorts of ideas that it was going to be a grand year of celebration because I celebrated my 60th birthday in March. And so being a big celebrant, I knew it was going to be awesome, as they say in Canada, where I now live. And I came to the New Year workshop and got so spiritually charged about it and wrote the intentions. And one thing that came to me was I found this site somewhere, this theme, live bold, wander far. And that became my theme for 2016.
Live bold.
And of course, those of us who come to the temple know that whatever you say, whatever your word is, it will happen. So I did live bold and I wandered far. My 60th birthday found me in Tanzania, getting ready to climb Mount Kilimanjaro, which I did. I went to India. I went to Rio for the Olympics. And in between did all sorts of other things.
Including coming to Jamaica 20 times.
And to church. And to church. For those who live here and only come once a year. I live in Toronto and I'm here all the time. it has been an amazing year, not just in terms of the travel, but for some of the things that I put down, like around relationships with my family and in particular with my son, Shane. And I just can't believe how that has just blossomed and what an amazing relationship we have. The best part about the traveling was that I actually came back from all this travel debt-free, with money in the bag. First time ever. And so I've been reflecting, what was it that weighed the difference this year? And I think one of the things, Reverend John hit on it yesterday when he was giving instructions, and that step three, Reverend John, he shared, when you have set your intentions, find a practitioner. Go to one of the practitioners and ask them to work with you. Well, I do that long time because Reverend John is my practitioner. And whenever I come to Jamaica, I meet with him, no matter, even on the way to the airport, as I shall tomorrow, on the way to the airport, I stop here and I get prayed up. And I always, you know, it's always something like this. So what's happening, Marguerite? And I tell him, he said, wow, you're amazing. What are we going to pray for now? And we pray. And I think that is really what has made the difference. That, yes, I have a personal relationship with Source, but also I have an accountability partner over here and someone who provides prayer support. So I really urge everyone, if you really want to make this the best year of your life, really do the things. You know, get rid of the stuff, set your intentions, and find that prayer support right here at the temple. And come to church. Thank you. Reverend John, I love you. And I know it was too long, but it's all right.
Okay. Thank you. Good evening, people.
Hi, Nadine.
My name is Nadine Martin. Last year, no time I come to church, probably once or twice.
Louder.
I didn't come to church regularly as I used to because I wasn't feeling good with myself. I feel a lot. I felt a lot of unforgiveness. Yeah, thanks. In my heart, because I felt that something went wrong, and I'm not feeling love, and I stayed away, and I become the person that when I first came here. When I first came here, I was lost, honestly lost. And I went to spiritual enrichment class last week, Tuesday, and there was something said that resonated and let me understand why I was like, oh, I was acting. And some part of it was not my fault, but acknowledging it, you have to do better. If you know what it is, you can do better. So I learned that last week. So I didn't come. And I got healed, very, very, very sick. Sick to the point that I was hospitalized. And they were saying all kind of bad stuff and what went to happen from what. And I draw upon the principle of here. Regardless, I wasn't feeling love and whatever. I was in the darkest part of my life where I have to call out again to source. And I wasn't loving the doctors. Spirit told me start loving them. And I started to love them. Honestly, they were like, yo, they talk too much, and this may happen to you, and this not. And I went back to what I learned here. And things start change. It start change for the better. And I thank God, and I just ask him deep down to just allow me to start loving, just love. Because as I said, where I do come from, they call it inner city. I call it the winner city. And I think I'm on the borderline, as I always say, from here and here I stand. I can be prima proper and I can be ranchy as I can be. So what I do now and what I was doing then was taking the principle from here and teaching where I come from. Let people understand that there is hope, because when I came here, there was none. I was indoctrinated with the devil thing, and you go to hell, and I still struggle with that. So most time I have a whole lamp on the books, then when I get, I rent from Reverend Ann. Thank you, Reverend Ann. I want to thank everybody, because everybody have their part, regardless of the situation that I come here, wounded and lost, seriously lost. And here give me a lot of hope. I have books now where I can run pan and feel good about and the affirmation. Yes, sometimes I try to meditate. Not all the time, I'm sorry. With all the kids, I can't meditate sometimes. But Reverend John teach me a lot too. A whole heap of people may have to let go because they were putting me down. Thank you, Reverend. So everybody, I thank Miss Rhonda, I thank Miss Walker, I thank everybody, because everybody play a part in molding me here. I'm in work in progress. As I said before, Miss Rhonda, I love me feel while I sing. This little lady, Miss Liz, when I first come here, Miss little lady, I sing her attitude. I know me not the attitude. Thank you very much. Thank you, Miss Rhonda. No, seriously, I want everything I saw here is what I always wanted. I wanted to dress fine. You see the ladies them at that temple. I try to, you know, be, but you want me to have something to work with. I have to work with the inner me first before I could really deal with the singing and all. And I am, as I said before, work in progress. So please continue to put me in the light. Please pray for me because I really need it. So thank you, and I love everybody. Thank you.
Yes, this is Miss Campbell. Well, those of you who know me know that this is not my favorite activity. However, I felt impelled to speak this evening, because one of the things that I have been putting on my list for a couple of years is to be published, and I thought that that was to happen in a particular way. However, you know, they say spirit moves in mysterious ways. As of December 2016, you're looking at the first Caribbean visual artist to be published in an international online journal, The Cultural. The Cultural and Pedagogical Inquiry Journal, published through the University of Alberta. And this came out of a visit I did to Calgary last year, which was, the visit was on my list the year before. And when I went back to Calgary last year, I met with a lot of colleagues that I went to school with and people who, when I lived in Calgary, you know. And so we got talking, a lot of us, and I talked about work, I was asked to submit some images of my work. And as a result of that, I'm in the journal. And further, because of the work submitted and also my CV, they have invited me to publish a Caribbean edition in 2019.
Okay, good evening, everyone.
Thank you, Sandra.
I'm very grateful, and that's the reason I just want to share what I'm grateful for. At the start of 2016 had looked as if it would have been another rough year for me because, you know, I had some serious lessons that I needed to learn, and I was very stubborn, and so I had a rough 2014, and I said I wasn't learning those lessons, and I came here, number one, even right out there, and I'm saying, why? And I was such a stubborn child, and 2014 was rough as a result. So was 2015. And then 2016, I decided to surrender. Reverend John had a class here on Troward. I don't remember the name of the class, I don't remember. But I started participating, and I came to that class. And I really decided that one of the things I was going to do, I was going to take on starting something and finishing it. Because I always start the classes, and by the class are like about 10 weeks, by week 7, always something come up. And I'm always out, and I decided I was going to finish it, and I decided I was going to put the principles to work. And I really believe that if you, in this consciousness, I shouldn't be struggling the way I was struggling. And so I decided to really take it on seriously, and with the good leadership, with the amazing leadership that is here, I decided to take it on. And I remember doing one class after the other. And I remember thinking, but I am it. No, seriously, I am all there is. And then I remember the Sunday. Yes, man, because Reverend John taught us that, you know, God is I am. All the presence and the power and everything there is also right here. And in those classes, he taught us how to do affirmative prayer and all of those kind of things. And the Sunday, I remember I sat on my bed. I said, look here now. All right. Where there's a vision, there's a provision. It's happening in the invisible before the visible. And if I am everything and there is nothing between me and what I want, then I'm going to declare what I want. Me fool, you see? So I declared. I mean, at the time, the bills that I had was higher than Kilimanjaro that Marguerite just climbed. No, seriously, true, seriously. And at the time, all I named a number, I named a figure. I said, look, I need a job this Sunday. I need a job that pays me X amount every single month. And I named it. And I said, well, I don't know where to send that application, and so I'm waiting on somebody to call me. I don't know where to send that because I declare what I wanted, and that was Sunday. And my consciousness was so high because of the work I was doing with Reverend John in class. Tuesday, I got a call. And the phone rang, and I'm like, hello? Yes, Cassandra, I hear you. No, I didn't tell anybody I'm job hunting. Where are you calling from? Where do you get my number? And I hung up the phone because, you know, these scamming things, and let me say, but hold on, didn't I? So the person called back, and the person said, well, Cassandra, somebody told me that you'd be open to a position. My name is Al Robbins with Mellow FM. I need to speak to you. I said, sure. Well, the first month, my pay was about $2,000 short what I'd asked for. This month, it almost doubled. So the mountain of bills that I had is now like a little anthill. You know, I can put my foot on it and stuff. And all of that came out of the work that I've done and really taking it on seriously. I never sent the application. I didn't know where to send it. I had no clue where to send it. And so all I did was set the intention, state exactly how much I wanted, and I've been getting that. But for 2017, I have some new instructions. I have some...
Good evening, like every year here. All I can say this year is be careful of what you ask for, because you're going to get it. This year was an exceptional year for me. Last year, right, it was an exceptional year. I have great years every year, really. And I take the good with the bad. Well, not bad. I don't want to call it bad. The lessons. But in 2015, you know, I went for a loan at a bank, not knowing where the money would come from to purchase. I wanted a building. Still want the building. Don't get it yet. Still focusing. But although I wasn't ready, I went for the loan. But what came from that meeting, because the person that I met with was very rude, very, very rude. And came home, bawled on my staff. Staff felt sorry for me, buy me lunch, sing for me and all these things. I have a fantastic staff, right? But what came out of it, after the tears dried up, was, you know, she was sent to push me in the direction that I needed to go. After the depression lifted, because I kept on wondering, what was it about me that made her think she could speak to me like that? And then it dawned on me that I went into the meeting almost begging. Because I wasn't confident. I wasn't selling myself. I went in there like a poor thing. So clearly, that's what she picked up on. And so I put on my list for 2016 that I would change how I operated. Hence the new haircut. How I saw myself, how I projected myself to people, how I presented myself as a whole. Still a work in progress, but what I can say is the whole of 2016, everything went as planned for me. It was a fantastic year. I have a fantastic staff that I've always dreamed of. They're not perfect, you know, but almost there. And I had a phenomenal year business-wise, even when people said things hard and didn't see through my doors, you know. And that is because I just changed how I viewed myself first, and how I just viewed everything and just knew that I deserved it. Every year I come up here and I talk good things because they happen to me. But they happen to me sometimes, I suppose, because, you know, I deserve it. But sometimes you don't even know that you deserve it. So what I have, the message that I have for everybody, just know you deserve it, claim it, and just whatever happened in your life, whatever it is, just pause for a moment, even if you're bald, and say, why did this happen? Take the lesson and just flip it. Thank you very much. That's all I want.
Okay, good evening, everyone.
Hello.
Listen, I don't want it to become a habit on me every year. But for those of us who were here last year, you probably would have seen me at the podium. You may be up sometime late at night and see some television ad that says, before, and they show you a picture of someone that go on some special diet, and then after. And sometimes it's not the same person that they show because of the transformation.
Okay.
So I decided to come on and just share my experience because I represent the before and actually the after. So it's the same me. And I just want to share a couple of things. This has been an amazing transition year for me. As part of the after, you know, save and except for the damage in Christmas, you know, I took on a transformation of sorts, physically. Certainly over the period, if you remember me, I lost some 50 pounds. But as I say, Christmas, you know, did some damage to that. In addition to that, though, I took the opportunity to spend some time, some good time with my sons. Sons, please stand so that they can see you, sons. Right. Really took the time to spend some time with them. If you remember last year when I was here, I announced everybody that, you know, I'm not going to work. I'm going to my yard, I'm sitting at home. And so, clearly, I have all the time in the world to spend time with my son to, you know, lose weight and exercise and did all of that. But also got the opportunity to did some own exploration. And I got exposed again to this journey that we're on, the hero's journey. And, you know, I'm thankful for so many things, certainly here at the temple and so on. But this experience called Hero's Journey, and you look it up, that we all embarked on and we continue to embark on at various stages of our life, have people who come into your life to lend support and become a mentor. And they are the ones who help you to transition, you know, through the difficult times, the questioning times, and ultimately, you know, be your support. This year for me, I couldn't make this opportunity pass without mentioning that just by being an example of what one can be, there was an amazing person in the form of Phaedra Saunders. Please stand, Phaedra. Sorry to embarrass you. Phaedra has been, by the way, you know, I have to be with my wife and all of that. And, you know that. Understand? You know, outside of my wife. Outside of my wife. No, she has been an amazing person who has embodied the experience and teaching of this church, one from which I learn a lot in an experiential way, is wanting to know and understand some of the teachings here, but the other is to be able to live. And she has been an example for me to emulate and follow, so much so that she continue to be a strength and support in my life. Now, I won't continue to babble, but I really wanted for you know, to come to stage just to share the idea that a lot of what we do here and the teachings here, it really does make a difference in your life. And I'm indeed thankful for this year, transition year in my life. And thanks for the support that I've gotten here. Mm-hmm.
Okay, going, gone.
We just want to say thank you. Boy, doesn't it feel great to hear all these sharings and the kindness and the generosity which persons just allow themselves to share with us. I think we should give them all a round of applause.